Hello and welcome. My name is Chris Wolpert. I'm a SuccessFactors consultant for Orbis People, and I want to do a quick video and demo to show you how the validation tool works for story reports and how you can validate standard reports for it. Okay, so I don't want to talk too much as an introduction and just show you. Just one important thing, I do will cut some loading time in between because performance is not the best to let you wait so long, so I just really will cut in between some places out where it's just loading. So where you can import standard reports, there is like a standard functionality with import that works with legacy reporting as well, and you normally can upload like a local file. But for the standard reports, only for store reporting, we have a content store. So you don't need to go to any website and download anything and then upload like a local file. You just need to go to the content store. So we have a lot of standard reports and store reporting already for Employee Central. More is to come, but that's not our topic today. I want to get the headcount and FTE standard report provided by SuccessFactors. One more point I just want to add here because I think it's super important. If you have questions to the report, what it does, how it's calculated, what it's showing, and so on, there are super helpful links here. Especially the functional and the technical documentation will help you a lot to understand how the report is created and why. Okay, patiently I waited now that the report is successfully imported. It can take a little bit time, so just don't close this window. You can do other stuff, but just don't close this window. If you see this message that the standard report is imported, you just can close this little window. You don't see it right away here. It's just because it's probably in UI interface. You just need to refresh the report center. You also can go to the home page and go back, but in a lot of cases you just simply need to do the refresh here, maybe to fill the gap. I would also, if you do work with store reports, save often and go back to the report center and refresh it if you miss something. Okay, we see the report. First, I just want to click and see it in the view mode, and now I'm going to wait a little bit till it's loaded. Okay, so there's still one element loading here on the bottom, but I want to use the time to tell you a little bit about the standard reports. The standard reports are obviously built on demo systems, so it really depends on the EC implementation and on the configuration of EC, how EC or any other module is built. So obviously standard reports doesn't always fit your own instance and configuration. If not, it will probably look a little bit like here. You get a lot of error messages now and you just see, okay, the standard report is not working for your instance. But there is a validation tool now, and it will tell you exactly what are the issues. Before, you had to look in the documentation and like basically check every field and table to see if you still use it like this way. Now what we do is we just switch to the edit mode, and I already go quickly into the data source, because the validation tool, not similar as Canvas reporting, is not like an own feature or functionality in SuccessFactors. It is embedded in the Query Designer. Happy that it was loading so quickly now. So the validation tool is basically on the top here, and you don't see anything yet, so don't get confused. What you need to do is either you finish the query or preview. Obviously, I think preview is just the way we should go here. And if you try to preview this query, the tool will basically check the configuration of EC and the report and will tell you what issues they have. You get a little error here on the bottom. This is basically telling you, okay, there are some issues, please check them. and then you see a number here with a question mark. You can click on the question mark and it will pop, like show all the objects which have issues. In this case now I just have the job information schema or table here. So if you have other objects involved in the query, you will see that here grouped by the object. So if I click on the job information, I do see like three errors here. So once I couldn't find the column, which is normally called in the standard report regular and temporary. There's an error in the calculated column, which with a start date. And there's a join or like a enter a table basically missing in the job grade. So normally if you can change things in something which is not found, like you have like the three dots, you can click on the dots and you have two options. First, edit, second, delete. Obviously, if you're like if you find that field like super useless and you don't want to use it, I don't know, like again check in the guide what is it used for or in which chart it's probably shown, you can simply delete it if you don't need it, or you replace it with another field which you actually have in the instance. So now for my example here, the customer, they don't use regular and temporary, they maybe use something else. And I'm not really familiar with this EC instance as well, but I would go instead of using regular and temporary, I maybe use employment type. So I just replaced this field from the standard report with an actually field I have in my instance. So I still have two issues. So let's have a look into the pay grade and then the start date. So pay grade, we probably don't use in this instance at all. So I do found it here. It's a foundation object and this is not used for this customer. So what I simply would do is I would check this table or field and just simply delete it. So we do had another issue with the calculation with the service dates. And like it might happen that the date used in the standard report is not used here, so let me check. If is null, so if the service date is null, then use the hire date, and if not, use the service date. So what I would say is we probably don't have a service date here, so I would just hope we maybe have a hire date here, so I would just go for the hire date here. Format it again and like click OK. So now I would just hope I would eliminate all the two errors. I would just start to finish the report because I personally think, okay, I did everything now I can to eliminate the errors the system was telling me I have issues with a standard report, and we wait a little bit till it's ready. Okay, now we already see we see some entities here, so it looks a little bit better. Also the filters here don't see any errors more. We still see some issues. In my experience, if you consider that, I mean I do know there's a second query here. I think before I tried it out, I think that there wasn't a big issue here. So if you have like save like your report, normally wait till there's a green agreement, and I would just save the report and then just going back into the report center, update it again and coming back here. So let me do that quickly to show you that it's normally working. Okay, great. Everything worked as planned. I went out of the report back into the report center. I refreshed. I maybe put it into the cut again. Sometimes, like a little tip, maybe what also helps is like doing the refresh here. The refresh, as soon as you click it, it will load and calculate everything again. There's like a little thing here which I could check. It's maybe like I think in this breakdown we do have like a dimension selected from this dimension we deleted, so we would need to take that out. But at least you see you actually could use the standard report now. So I hope this little demo or example was a little bit helpful for you, and I think you're ready to go to explore all the standard content, or even if you have issues from your own report from one to into another instance to check. One last tip I want to give you away is if you do have hard filters in the query designer, and you filter out, for example, like a specific country or like maybe just active employees or something like that, please have in mind that this could be different in other instances, because in the background of that filter, if it's a text filter, it could be an ID, a pick list ID. So you don't see the ID, but maybe the validation tool would not recognize. And like again, like it's a still early development for the validation tool. So be careful with the validation. I'm not 100% sure if it will detect all the issues, but in our case, we're good to go here to explore further. Thank you very much and have a great day. Bye.